Okay, so this is a review of my 2018 Ford Expedition XLT Max. I thought I'd start with the trunk space since most mothers like to know how much trunk is going on back there. All right, so to open the trunk, there's this little button here I'll push, and it'll open by itself. And here's the trunk space. So here we have these compartments under here. I store straps for my surfboard rack down in here. I have towels in this one just for emergencies. We have kind of a little cubby space here. You can put the net. It's another little cubby space. They've got this 12 volts, so you can plug in stuff. So one thing I really like about this is when you push this button, when you push these buttons right here, they operate the seat backs. So when I push, it's 2L, that's the second row left seat. Here, I'm gonna push the button and watch what happens. Same for 2 middle. 2 right. Also, we have third row left right here. And third row right here. And now you have this huge space right here. Let's see. I'm gonna push that down. Here, I'm gonna get out a tape measure, measure how much space we have from the front seat all the way to the trunk. Okay. From the front seat all the way to the trunk, it ends at about 101.5 inches. So that's a ton of space. So this is the back of the trunk right here, this little notch. So max trunk space you have is about 28 and a half, give or take. And side to side here. Let's see, side to side, there's a glare 51 inches. Quite a bit. So let me show you how to put the seats back up. So for the third row, which is automatic, it'll go back up. You just push this button. Second row is not automatic. You have to. Okay, so for the second row, you have to come grab and just push it up manually. I leave the second row, this second one down, so my kids can climb across into the back, just so it makes it easier. But I'll put it up for now. So you just push them all up. And there you go. I am going to put this middle one back down so I can climb into the back and show you a couple cool things that are happening back there. So I'll pull this to release. Climbing in the back. So, one thing that's really great if you're an adult riding in the very back, this reclines. You push this button, you can recline. So I'm gonna push it forward because I just put it back. So I mean, now I'm sitting like straight up. I'm gonna go back now. My son loves this one, he leans it back. Another thing is they have charging ports. cup holders, clearly. This side, same thing. Reclinable. Charging port. Cup holder. We got air vents. Coat hanger. The middle seat has a strap that comes down and around. Lights right here. In my Suburban, my kids did not have access to operating a light in the very back of the vehicle, which was always very annoying. Because then I had to turn on all the dome lights while we were driving down the road if they needed to see something. Alright, I'm gonna climb up here now. Normally there's a car seat in this seat right here, but I took it out for the review. Here we have window operations. Got a little speaker. More air vents. Here's another little light switch. Handle. This car has a moonroof, so you can see all the way up and out from the second row, basically. You can see straight up. Here, I love this. So here I like this. You can operate the radio from back here. So I'm gonna turn it down. From here you can operate airflow. You can turn it up, down. Got your charging ports. Even got one of these, baby. I think we all need one of those. Let's see, what's this one? Oh, you got your 12 volt down here. Got a little storage compartment. Let's see, you know, you got the typical little pouches in the back of the seats. Let's see. This side has a window light. This as well. Got your cup holders there. Cup holder here. Extra space. Here's some more extra little space in there as well. Another cup holder. I mean, this car has endless amounts of cup holders. I know, I moved it. So each side has like at least two cup holders a seat. It's crazy. Okay, I'm gonna move up to the front. Okay, so here we are in the front. Currently it tells me that my back door is open. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna find the little button here that says trunk space. I'm gonna push that button and move your head, Daddy. And it's gonna close for me. Also, there is a ton of sun coming in, so I'm gonna find my close this button, close the moonroof, as they call it. And here it goes. There we go, nice and dark. So I'm just gonna start with some of the features here. This is my light. Flip that and you can flip this one. This is the light for the entire car. So when I flip that one, all the lights come on. This one, if I push that, the lights won't open when a car door opens. This one just kind of lifts the hatch on the moonroof. This one opens the moonroof, like opens the window itself. Here's a cute little mirror for when your kids are fighting in the back. You can pull down your mirror and see who's back there. Who's the one punching the other one? We got sunglass holder. Of course, all these are always in the new car. You got your garage door opener. We have the presets on the seats. 1, 2, 3. You got the window lock for the kids so they can't be opening and closing the windows. also have, this is, this moves the window here, so you click the window you want and then you can move it in and out. See, when I push the arrows, they move. Another thing this car has is the, don't know if you can see that, but it has the blind spot detector. So that light will light up when there's someone hanging out right there on you. Which I do like, because I have noticed that when you look over your shoulder in the car to check to see if anyone is behind in your blind spot, you can't see. So that is very convenient. One thing that I haven't seen before on a car, because I had a 2002 Suburban previous to this one, is these move the pedals for you. So if you're like really, really, really short, you can move your pedals. So these are coming forward right now, but I prefer mine as close to the floor as I can get. This little knobby here moves the steering wheel. Let's go up and down. All right, it's feeling a little hot in here right now. So I'm going to, this one controls my side, but I have it set to dual operation right now. So both sides will change. You can set it to where the passenger is in charge of his side and you're in charge of your side. And here's the airflow. How much do you want? Looks like we have seat heaters on. So this is passenger's seat heater, which I'm gonna turn off. And mine too, I'm turning off. This button right here is heated steering wheel, which is awesome. I'm turning that off though. So if you wanna operate the back air conditioning, you just hit the climate button. Come over to the rear, and now you have complete operation of what's happening in the back with air conditioning. If you don't want your kids to be in charge of air conditioning, rear lock, and now you are only in control. Obviously, you've got your Sirius XM radio, got your phone operations, navigation system, which I've never actually used. I've only had this car for less than 2 weeks. Apps, settings, so you can set what you want the radio to sound like, and set your clock, which I don't need to change. There was one that was really cool. So display, you know, at nighttime when it's really bright and you hate all this light in your face, you can just turn it off. And then to wake it up, tap it. You can also dim it if you need to, the brightness. Oh, ambient lighting is really cool. So you can pick, there are these lights that stay on in your car, or they come on at night. You can choose what color you want the inside of your car to be lit up at night. So we have ours on blue right now. Let's see what general does. Oh, language, what you want your gauge to be reading in, miles, kilometers, temperature, Fahrenheit, Celsius, you know, all that stuff. So this here is really cool. I actually use to go down my driveway sometimes. It's pretty steep. Yeah. It's downhill descent. So when I push that, it says it'll, it basically controls my car's, it keeps it in a lower gear for me when I'm going down. And honestly, I don't even use the gas or anything. It completely holds back for me 100%. So I'm gonna turn that back off just by pushing the button. This one, there's another button here. I'm gonna push, I never use this one. Traction control off and on. Hazards. This one is the lane keeping, which I rarely use the lane keeping. So there it is on. When it comes on, these little lines pop up, and when it's activated and working properly, they turn green. So I'm gonna turn that off. This button is the auto start stop button. So when you come to a stoplight and you're sitting there for more than like 3 seconds, your car turns off automatically. So let's say you're, I don't know, sitting in traffic and you don't want your car turning on and off, you can just push that button and it will not turn on and off anymore. So I haven't used that one yet, but when it's like really hot outside and your car keeps turning on and off, then it gets kind of warm inside your car as well. So what else is there? Okay, so here I can these buttons right here control the screen. There's little tabs, so when I push over, I can see all this stuff. So we've got my gauge view. It tells me tire pressure. Let's check it out. Oh, I've got a couple. They're not all the same, which is actually pretty convenient. Here's the digital speedometer, engine information, transmission temperature. Let's see what else. We have towing. We got the towing package, so it'll pretty much show you everything. Let's click on trailer light status. So you know, trailer detected. Connection checklist. Let's see. Interesting. Okay. Oh wait, did I finish looking at this one? Tire pressure, digital speedometer, engine information, transmission temperature. Okay, that's all the ones on that one. So we're gonna go over here. Oh, this one's really cool actually. Cause you can like see it tells me what grade I'm parked at. So I've got a 4% tilt. I'm level here. Which is actually really cool. It's like when you're parked on a hill, you can be like, oh, or when you're off-roading, clearly, because it says off-road status. Let's see. So we have pre-collision, cruise control, DTE calculation. Ah, okay. I don't need that. Lane keeping system. Oh, I turned my alert up because I could barely feel it before. It kind of like the steering wheel gets kind of like stiff feeling, and then when you're like drifting in your lane and your seat's supposed to vibrate, which I haven't felt that yet. Advanced settings. Oh, that's for like the outdoor, the key and stuff. Let's see. Blind spot, cross traffic, driver alert, rear park aid, pre-collision. Yeah. So that's about everything. Let's check out, there was one I saw here, I went advanced. Vehicle. Okay, so the easy entry exit. So we turned it off yesterday because your seat will move back every time you turn your car off, which gets a little annoying for me. Some people might like it. So then the lighting here, we have our auto high beams on, which I actually really, really like, which means the lights turn on, the high beams come on automatically and they turn off automatically if the car's coming at you. Then we got locks here, auto lock, auto unlock, remote unlock, mirrors, auto fold, which I love that, because as soon as you lock your car, the mirrors fold in. And then you don't have to worry about people bumping your mirrors. Alarm. Perimeter sensing. Yeah, that would be, we have certain things set the way we want them. Power lift gate, which I love the power lift gate. I would not turn that off. But you know, it's up to you. Wiper controls, courtesy wipe. Oh, I have rain sensing. I did not even know that. Rain sensing. So when it starts to rain, your wipers will control themselves. Okay, so moving on, here's the shifting knob. So you can go, one thing that's kind of cool, which I've never really used, I don't find it super practical for me. So you put yourself in drive, and let's say you just, you come up, you open the door. Like, when you turn your car off, it puts itself in park for you. I'm gonna turn my car back on. So you got your manual, which we use going downhill. Here's the plus and minus, so you wanna go up from first, you go to second, third, second, first. Then we got the four-wheel drive, so we can turn it into two high, four all-wheel. Cup holders, clearly. It's got this key. This is the iPhone charger. So you just lay your phone on here. Only for the iPhones that have that capability. Mine does not. So I have my cord. So we got the chargers here. Oh, we got another 12 volt. Alright, I'm gonna go get in the passenger seat here. Okay. So there's a bunch of space over here in the passenger seat. We got more cup holders, window operations, lock, obviously air vents. So you got your typical glove compartment. And I just discovered this one yesterday. There's a secret one. Ooh. It's always fun when you find new things in your car. So let's see what car exactly I have. Okay, so here's the car that we bought. It's a 2018 Expedition XLT 4x4 XLT 8 passenger, 3.5 liter EcoBoost V6 engine, 10-speed automatic transmission with select shift. Okay, the 10-speed automatic transmission is awesome, okay? Like, whenever you step on the gas to get going, you never lose power. It just keeps accelerating. It is amazing, which I absolutely love that. Oh, I'll have to show you the 10-speed automatic on the. Okay, so when I am driving my car, I keep it on the fuel economy view. It tells me how many miles per gallon I'm getting, and currently I'm getting 16.6. So for the 10-speed automatic transmission, when I put my car in drive, this pops up. So you can tell what gear you're in currently. So I'm just gonna back up. I'm gonna back up real quick. So here's my backup cam. Got my dog out there too. Beep, beep, dog. Beep, beep. Okay. So here we are backing up. Which I love this cam. But I also like using the mirrors too, at a certain point. You do have to be careful on this camera because you don't know how far, like, if I turn too sharply, I could run into that wall right there. So you still gotta pay attention to your front end. I know some people might just completely forget the fact that they have a front end when they're using their rear view camera. So anyway, so I'm gonna drive forward and see if it shifts up for me at all. Okay, so as you saw, it went up. I think the highest number it went to was 3 right there. But yeah, that's awesome. I love it. Okay, so when I like to go places and I don't want to carry my key with me, I'll stick my key in there and I'll close this and I'll turn the car off. Then what I'll do is I'll get out. Don't touch anything. Okay. I'll get out and I'll just click these two buttons. Car's locking. And then to get back in, I'll come up and I'll push my secret code, which I'm not gonna show. Car's unlocking. And you can get back in without having to worry about taking your key or losing your key anywhere. As a matter of fact, I leave my key in the car like 90% of the time. Because it's like, well, why carry it with me when I can just leave it here? So that's my review. Here's the full car. This thing's awesome. So if you're considering getting one, I highly, highly recommend. I've got the roof. Mine came with a roof rack. It's obviously something you can pick in your package. So yep. It's a little dirty because it rained last night. So yep, thank you for watching.